you just released an EP, and Rockefeller produced it, and he produced like Green Day, and you were, I read like you were a huge fan of Green Day, so what, how did you react to them, that guy producing you?
Oh, it was amazing. I mean, you heard one of my songs, and I literally freaked the fuck out. Like, he wanted to meet me.
You're,
it was a dream come true. Like, I, Green Day, Dookie started for me. And
that's a great album.
Yeah, and then thankfully, like, I wrote a song when I was signed shortly after I got my record deal, and one of the executives played it for him, and he freaked out, and he wanted to meet me, and it was fucking incredible.
You were doing, like, YouTube videos, and somebody found you on YouTube?
I was, yeah, I got discovered. I did a cover of Asher Ross, I Love College, and it was insane because I couldn't get hired. I was trying to get hired at Costco, Starbucks. I'm literally playing street corners with an acoustic guitar. I was struggling out in L.A. for years, and overnight I got a record deal. It was like 2 weeks later, and I got an opportunity to prove myself. It was amazing.
You have a lyric video for Get Money. Why did you pick that as the single for your album, for your EP?
I was broke as fuck.
And I saw it online. It was really cool.
Thank you. You know what? It was actually really rewarding for me to go out there because when I wrote that song, it was about thinking that money's going to solve all your problems, right? And I think it's easy to get sold the idea, at least for me growing up watching MTV Cribs and feeling a false sense of entitlement.
Yeah.
And after going out on the street and meeting all those people and hearing their story, it's just like, how the fuck could I ever, you know, be bummed out about my situation? I'd be thankful what I have. It's like there's a lot of people out there that have a lot less, and I think it's easy to get sold the idea of consumerism and keeping up with the Joneses and all that other bullshit, and you get kind of lost in that, and you focus more on what you don't have. And I mean, making that video was incredible.
Was that your favorite song to record or one in?
It's my favorite to play live. The band actually kind of jams. They go off and do their own thing, and they start shredding, and I like watching them kind of just do their thing and go ape shit.
This is your first year on the Warped Tour, right?
It is, yeah. I just popped my cherry and exploded everywhere, and that's that.
You're doing the entire thing, or...?
I am. I'm doing the full tour,
that's awesome.
Yeah.
For first year on the tour, that's pretty good.
It's exciting. It's really, really exciting. I'm stoked. I want to see Falling in Reverse, so they keep putting our set times together, so I keep missing them.
I don't remember what time they were playing it today. But I was watching your set, so I think I missed them.
You probably missed them then.
Do you have any tour plans after Warped Tour, or are you going to start working on more music?
You know, I don't know yet. I just finished a full-length album, so we're just wrapping that up.
You're going to release...
Yeah, I released an EP about a week ago, and I'm going to do a full-length album later on in the year, early next year. And so it kind of depends on, you know, a couple different things, but we're looking to go out this fall.
Do you have any funny tour stories that you can share?
The tour just started. Nothing crazy has happened yet. I got pecked in the head by an ostrich. We were driving out to Salt Lake City. Stopped off at a Flying J. There's a petting zoo next to it. So I went to go take my picture with an ostrich, and he just nailed my fucking head. I don't know if he thought my hair was grass.
Maybe.
Or what, but he nailed my head.
I don't think they're very friendly.
He seemed kind of like a fucking grouch, actually. I was like, dude, fucking chill out, man. You know, I wanted to give him a hug, a smile, and a Coke, but he wasn't having it.
What else would you like to share about, like, that we haven't covered? Or do you have anything you want to say to your fans?
You know, I just love doing the Warped Tour. It's been amazing because I'm meeting so many people in just a week. And it's amazing just meeting new people, going to new towns. A lot of people that are actually familiar with the music, which is surprising to me because I still just picture myself in my shitty apartment fucking doing MySpace. So it's crazy to actually see kids responding. So that's that.
I hadn't heard of you before the Warped Tour kickoff, and that was the first time I saw you, and you were really great, so I was like, I gotta get an interview with them.
Well, thank you. I'm glad we got to hang out. It was a lot of fun. I love your hair. We're pretty much like Christmas, me and you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks so much.